Hello everyone. Today I'm going to teach you factorization. Now remember, factorization comes in paper 1, so there's need actually for you to understand the topic very well. To begin with, we are going to look at the types of factorization. Okay, so basically we have 3 types of factorization. Now, for you to understand this topic very well or to answer any kind of question based on factorization, you need to understand the type. Okay, so that when you see the question in the exam, you'll be able to identify that this is difference of 2 squares, therefore I'm supposed to carry it in this way. Okay, so the 3 types of factorization that we have are: the first one is difference of 2 squares, then there's quadratic factorization, and then there's the grouping. Okay, now what are the differences? What are some of the differences that are there, or how do you tell that this question is falls under difference of 2 squares? In difference of 2 squares, there are only two terms in here. There are only two terms. What do we mean by two terms? It can be, for example, for x squared minus 1. Okay, in here, this is one term, there is also another term, two terms. Okay. If there are two terms and always in between there is a minus, conclude to say this is difference of 2 squares. Okay, so now the terms here again, it's not always that they'll be in this form. They can also be in fraction form. Okay, they can be in fraction form. Take for instance this, minus 1 over 50, something like this. This is still difference of 2 squares. Why? There are two terms, 1, 2, and there's always a minus. Always there must be a minus in between. That gives you to say, oh, this is difference of 2 squares. Okay, that is about difference of 2 squares. The next one is the quadratic factorization. Under quadratic factorization, there are 3 terms. Okay, so we can say in here there are 3 terms. Okay, quadratic factorization, there are 3 terms. What we mean by that is, it can be maybe, let me say x squared minus 4x minus maybe plus 1. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, conclude to say this is quadratic factorization. And always the power of the variable, the highest power of the variable is always 2 or square. Okay, then it is the quadratic factorization. Okay, then the other one is the grouping. In grouping here, there will always be 4 terms. 4 terms. Okay, for example, I can ask you, or they can ask you to factorize something like this in the exam. Make it 4ab plus 3ac minus 2 bc plus BD like that. Okay, BD like that. So in here, you cannot solve this question through quadratic factorization, no, or difference of 2 squares, no. But this is grouping because there are 4 terms. 1, 2, 3, 4. That is the meaning of 4 terms. Okay, so now let's quickly go through the examples of each of these 3 types of factorization. So we have the example here. Factorize the following completely. Okay, factorize the following completely. The first one is 32x squared minus 50. And then the second one is 2y squared plus 29y minus 15. And then the third one is 4ab plus 6ac minus 6bd minus 9cd. Okay, so these are the 3 examples. So follow clearly as I answer all the 3 questions, then any question in factorization, you'll never get it wrong. So let's look at the solutions of these 3 examples. So the first one is 32x squared minus 50. How would you factorize this? First of all, it's about identifying the type. So you can see that these are 2 terms and there's a minus in between. Then this is a difference of 2 squares. So you should have carrying out this, I'm solving this using difference of 2 squares. Now, before maybe looking at this, I can simply ask you, first of all, maybe a question to say, how would you factorize this? We've got 4x minus 2. Okay? 4x minus 2. Then I ask you to factorize. To factorize this means you look, there are two terms here, but you look for what is common in both. Okay, there's 4x this side, on the other side there's a 2. So what is common here? You conclude to say the common thing here is 2. Because 2 can go in that, 2 can go in there. It's just a 2, not x. There's no x here. So it's just a 2. So now we have identified the common thing that it is 2. I'll open the bracket, then I'll say 2 into 4, it will give me 2. And then there's x there. Then minus 2 into 2 gives me 1. I have done the factorization. Now these are simple kind of factorization, which will be, can be applied in all the three. First of all, understand that. Right, so now we've got 32 x squared minus 50. The use of difference of two squares is to make both sides squares. That's a meaning. Both sides squares. So meaning this side and also this side squares. But the question we have here is 32 cannot be written in any way, in any form. 32 and 50 here cannot be written in square form. What we mean by square form, what I mean by square form is 4 can be written in square form, because I can say 4 is the same as 2 squared. This is what I mean by square form. But there's no such kind of arrangement where 32 is concerned. There's no number I can multiply itself 2 times that will give me 32. There's no number I can multiply itself 2 times that will give me 50. Meaning, in this case, there's simple factorization that has to be done before the actual before the actual difference of two squares. That's the meaning there. So what we need to do is we have to identify what is common in both terms. Okay? You will agree with me that what is common in both here is 2. Because 2 can go into that, 2 can go into 50 as well. So what is common here is 2. Then I'll say 2 into 32, that gives me 16. Then there's x squared here minus 2 into 50 is 25. Okay, so that's the first factorization in there. But this is not difference of two squares. This is not the only way, alright? This is not the only way. Or questions may not be in this same way. There are questions like 4x squared minus 1. This question does not require this stage. Because if you look at the terms here, 4 can be expressed in square form, 1 can be expressed in square form. Therefore, this will be direct. But this one wasn't direct because the numbers which were given cannot be expressed in square form. So there was need, first of all, to express, to factorize in this way, so that we've got 16 here and 25. Then from there, we carry it on. The 2 will just be coming down until the final answer. So we have 2 here. Then inside the brackets, I've got 16. The x is already squared. Alright? Then the 16 here means this can be expressed in terms of a square. And how will the 16 be written? 16 is the same as saying 4 squared. Okay? And then there's x squared here minus 25 is the same as 5 squared. So express everything in square form. After doing that, ignore the squares. First of all, write the 2 like that. Then in brackets here, ignore the squares. Just get the bases. So if we ignore the squares here, we get the bases. We have 4x minus 5. Then the other bracket, you just change the sign. The same way it is, 4x plus 5. In that way, you are done. This is the way we apply difference of two squares. This is not the only one. This time around in the new syllabus, now they move. The examiners are now good in setting fractions. Okay, for example, they give you 1 over 2y squared minus 1 over 50. Okay, like this. Factorize completely. It ends there. So with this, again, a 50 here cannot be expressed, like I said in there.
Right? So what you need to do here, there is simple factorization, first of all, that we did here. So what is common here? Again, the two cannot be expressed. So what is common here is, since these are fractions, don't say 2 is common. No, that is wrong. 2 is not common. What is common here? Since it's a fraction, it is 1 over 2. Half is what is common. Because this is a fraction. These are both fractions. So you also need to consider the numerators. So what is common here is half. Then you open brackets. This half, or 1 into 1, that gives you 1. Over 2 into 2, that gives you 1. Then y squared here, there will be y squared there. Then minus this, will be 1 into 1, that gives you 1. Over the 50 here, that is 2 into 50, gives you 25. Okay? Again, here, you do the same thing now, which we did here, by expressing everything in square form. Then that means my 1 over 2, write it here, my 1 over 2 will be just like that. Expressing everything here in fraction form, I mean in square form, it will be 1 squared, it's the same as 1, over, the y is already in square, so it will be y squared minus, the 1 will be 1 squared over, 25 will be 5 squared, everything in square form. After you express everything in square form, ignore the squares. Okay, which will be 1 over 2. If I ignore all the squares here I have 1 over y minus, then here of 1 over 5. You see, the first bracket will have a minus, the next bracket will have a plus. 1 over y plus 1 over 5. This is how to go about it. So, this is about factorization, difference of two squares. This is how to go about it. Let's move on to the next example. The next example is different from the first one because this one has got three terms, 1, 2, 3. So meaning this is quadratic factorization. So how to go about quadratic factorization? You see, you identify first of all the sum and the product. What we call the sum and the product. The sum always get the coefficient of y. Okay. Now, this is not the only variable that can be used. Any other variable, when you say variable, we mean letters in mathematics, okay? So any other variable can be used. It can be x, it can be z, it can be any other variable. So when you are getting the sum, always get the coefficient of who? The middle part, which is will be always y here, or x here, or z. And these must always be arranged in this order. If they are not arranged, arrange them before you do the factorization. And the order must always be the y squared, then followed by y. This is the same as y to the power 1. This is the same as y to the power 0. Okay? That's why you're not seeing y here. It's because of the laws of indices. Remember, any number of variable raised to the power 0 is 1. So that's why you're seeing y 0 here is the same as 1. So 1 times 15, that's why you're not seeing the y here. That's the way to go. Understand? Then, it should always be in that arrangement. This is very important because this comes as well in paper 2, whereby you will be asked to solve this, which carries 5 marks. Remember that. So we'll still come back to such kind of questions. And then in the same paper 2, they will ask you to graph this, which is paper 2 section B. Right? They will ask you to graph the same kind of quadratic function. When it comes to graphing, remember always that it can either be this or it can be that. That's the way those kind of curves or quadratic graphs appear. It will be either this way or that way. And then there's also solving for 5 questions. Those for 5, I mean for 5 marks. Those for 5 marks that mean means that they cannot be factorized, but you need to use maybe the quadratic formula. Right, so coming back to this, we've got the sum. So the sum I have here will get the coefficient of y, which is 29. So I'll get the 29 there. Then the product here, you multiply the first one and the last one. Multiply them. Okay, so if there's no number here, treat this to have a 1. So you multiply 1 times the other number there. Okay, so now in this time around here, there's a 2. So I'll say 2 times negative 25, I mean 2 times negative 15. So it will be 2 times negative 15. This gives me negative what? 30. That is my product. Negative 30 there. You write negative 30 as simple as that. Then after writing these 2, you will now look for 2 numbers. When you add That's the meaning of sum. Add. Okay? Plus. When you add them, they should give you 29. The same two numbers that you get here, when you multiply, that is product. When I multiply them, they should give me negative 30. What are the two numbers? When I add, they should give me 29. The same two numbers, when I multiply, they should give me negative 30. How do you get those two numbers quickly? You go to the product. Your product is the negative 30. So the two numbers are coming from 30. In short, we are saying they are coming from factors of 30. So if we say factors of 30, if we say factors of 30, we are referring to 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 10, I think as well as 30. Okay? So these are the factors. So the two numbers I'm talking about, they are here. They are here. So always get the two numbers from the product. Okay? So what are those two numbers? I have to pick two numbers here. When I add them, they should give me 29. When I multiply them, they should give me negative 30. What are those two numbers? You will find that the two numbers is 1 and 30. Now, I said add, they should give you 29. Yes, these two, when I add them, they'll give me 29. Reason is, this is negative 30. Okay, this, there's a negative here. So meaning these two numbers here, 1 must be a negative. And that, because this is negative 30, and this is positive, the bigger one will be positive here. So this will be negative 1. So the two numbers are negative 1 and 30. If you want, you can now try and see if it will give you the correct answer. Try to add this. Negative 1 plus 30. This gives you 29. Try to multiply. Negative 1 times 30. This gives you negative 30. That's what we need. So when you identify now, your next step is it, you substitute these two numbers here. That is where you substitute always. So you write the first term the way it is, which is 2y squared. And then I will remove this and put these two numbers. Now since where I am removing this y, there is need to put y in these two numbers. If it is x, you put x. If it is r, you put r. Okay, so in this case, there's y, there's also y there. So I'll put these two numbers here. So this is negative 1y. Now this is repetition in mathematics. There's no 1y. You just say y. So this, I'll write it negative y. That is this. Then this is positive. I'll say plus 30y. Then the last term, minus 15. Okay? So that is how to substitute it there. After substituting, this now takes us to the other type of factorization, which we call grouping, because there are now four terms. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so now since there are four terms in that way, we group them to two. We do it like that. We introduce brackets in that way. After introducing the brackets, you factorize now commonly. You factorize what is common in both. You find that what is common here is y, because there is y, there is y. You do it that way. What will remain here will be 2. Then since there are 2y, there will be 1y that will remain. Then minus 1y into y, that gives you 1. So it will be in that way. Then on the other side, plus what is common here is 15, because 15 can go into 30, 15 can go into 15. So 15 into 30, that gives you 2, and then there's y there, okay? Then minus here, minus. And then 15 into 15 gives you 1, okay? So now here, this is the question. These in brackets at this stage should always be the same. If they are different, you go back. That means you have made a mistake somewhere. Here, these should always be the same. The essence here is that if they are the same, we are only going to pick 1. So, what is outside? There is y here. Also, on the other side, there is plus 15. You put this in bracket. Since these are common or are the same, I will write 1. This ends your calculations. Okay, so that is how to go about factorization. Then we look at the last part of the question. 4ab plus 6, ac minus 6, bd minus 9, cd. So this is what we call grouping. Factorization by grouping. There are four terms in there. So you just group them. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. In some areas, you will not find them arranged like this question, the way it is. In some areas, there is need. First of all, you try to arrange them, what and what, then you group them. But in this case like this, it is already arranged. So what I'll do is, I'll just copy the way it is here, which I'll say 4AB plus 6AC minus 6BD minus 9CD. Then I'll group them 2-2. So I'll say this and also on the other side like that. And then, it's like now at this stage, you are somewhere here, okay? And then you look for what is common in both. Okay, brackets. So here, what is common? We find that 2 can go into, first of all, the numbers before the variables. So the 2 can go there. So I'll say 2. When you try to erase this. Okay, so 2 can go into that. So I'll say 2. And then, before that. There's also a variable which is common, and that is A. Okay, so what is common here is 2A. Then 2 into that gives me 2. What will remain here will be B. And then plus 2 into 6 gives me 3. And then there is A as well there. So what will remain there will be C. So I've done my factorization on that. Then minus on the other side as well. Excuse me. On the other side as well, there is what is common here. What number can go into 6? And 9, first of all, you find that to be 3. So 3 is common. And then in terms of letters, D, there's D here, there's D. Then I open my bracket there, 3 into 6 gives me 2. Okay, the letter that will remain there will be B. Okay, so don't be too quick to write a minus there. That's not correct. So there's a minus here. This minus and the minus, same signs. Gives you a plus. So this turns into a plus. So this and this, remember when you introduce brackets, means you are multiplying this by everything inside there. Right, so there's a plus there. Then 3 into 9 will give me 3. And the letter that will remain on the other side is a C. Then you can close your bracket there. Then now you try to compare if you can still further go a big step from there. So we have this and this. Are they the same? Oh, yes, they are the same. Then I can get what is outside, which is 2a, 2a here. Then on the other side, minus 3d, 3d there. Then since these are the same, I only pick one, which will be 2b plus 3c. My factorization ends there. So these are the three types of factorization you expect in the exam. Thank you for watching.